Well, before QNET, my journey, I mean, I was employed in a hotel, and I got a job at very young age of 21 years old, and I was quite thrilled up, as usual, you know, as everyone is. Parents were excited. I went up in Bahrain. That was the place I got the job. Then I realized that it's not easy, I mean, to survive out there. And hotel field was not like the 9-to-5 job. And I had to work about 15, 16 hours. The more hours you put in, the more you make your bosses happy, chances of getting higher growth. And after 2 years, I already felt like tired, you know, being 20, 22 years old. And then I looked at my seniors, and then I thought that I don't want the life like them. I mean, that was not my ideal thing. I wanted to do something for myself, and I did not know what it was, right? And that's when, by God's blessing, you know, this fantastic business came into my life. I joined the business just because of my friend and upline, the partner Arun George. He and AVP Balaji, we three were friends much before this business. And we studied almost in the same college, and we had landed up in Bahrain. He came in after me. But one day he came up and shared this idea called network marketing. And I had a very, very, very bad image about network marketing based on some Indian companies, you know, way back in 1998. So I told him, I outrightly rejected him. I said, I'm not for this. And but he went ahead and he joined. And looking at his courage and the way he did it, we just jumped in. I thought, let me just join, I mean, just for his sake. So there was no purpose, there was no reason. I did not understand anything. I just joined. I studied in India with my father. He was in army, so he took me around. Like army is like three years stationed, you know, so they take you to different stations around the country. And finally, when he built the house in my hometown, which is Kerala, I never got a chance to live there. And then I moved to hostel, learning my college, hotel management. So there was an emotional thing that I'd never stayed in my hometown and my home place, you know. And when I got my job, and then I realized that when you get a job in Bahrain, you need to submit your passport to the employer, right? And you get only to smell and see the passport after 2 years. It's not with you. And you feel like, you feel terrible. You feel like a slave, you see, when you don't have your passport with you. And that really was a feeling which I did not understand until I wrote down that. And when I wrote down, the first dream which came into my life, I mean, that day was to be able to see my parents whenever I want to, right? And to be with them, right? To stay with them, to enjoy at least some moments of their last times, you know. And that was something emotional, bigger than a car, bigger than a house, or bigger than marriage. And that's what kept pushing me on, right? And then there are a few others. I mean, the rest all follows, you know. Then there was something about taking them on a world trip, because he showed me India. I wanted to show the world to him. And I completed that in 2006, after writing down the dream. About 5 years it took, but the journey was smooth, and I really enjoy. Yeah, I mean, it, like typically people would say, I mean, success has definitely shown me the brighter side of life and all that. But I think success in this particular company, I mean, in this organization called the V, it just shows you the person who you are, and it just makes you a better human being. And that's what I really value, and what I learned from Datusri and the Chief and the rest of the V partners. But yeah, I mean, I've seen life, I mean, I've seen people in different walks of the life. Making money, you can make in 100 ways, right? But making money through this journey, where you are touching lives and, you know, you're helping people out there, that's complete different satisfaction. And I think that it just mellowed me down. It just made me humble. I was an arrogant person, I mean, working in a hotel, because I used to think I know everything. In terms of legacy, I always think about the teachings, what we have been receiving, you know. And we are just completing 20 years, and the coming 20 years, the ideal legacy would be to carry on this message. So I just want to contribute as much as possible, to have this sense of service with leadership, service in life, service as a parent, service, you know, service in general sense in the normal life. That's, if I can do that, I would be very happy. I mean, I'll continue to be there until I'm alive. But now the dreams are more about myself, but again, my people below. Because I can see at least about 5-6 Manojas down there who are still like me, how I was about 18 years back. And it gives me great satisfaction in pulling at least few of them and making them realize and giving them a chance to feel what I felt 18 years back, you know. And that's my dream now, right? To make them the next Manojas in my life, right? So that I can see that sparkle and twinkle in their eyes.